excited for this video, mainly because for selfish reasons, I want to look back on what were the biggest things that happened in tech in 2023. When you take a step back and look at all the events, all the biggest things to occur in the tech industry around news and headlines this past year, it was a wild one. So this video is purely for your entertainment and also, I mean, it's really interesting and fascinating to look back on what were the biggest things to happen in tech in 2023. Let's start with January. Why does January 2023 feel like forever ago? I mean, I know it's about a year ago, but it really feels even longer than that. But there were some big things that occurred right beginning off the year. First one, of course, you have to understand, it was November of 2022. So leading up to 2023 that ChatGPT was released. So we kept on seeing, especially early on this past year, a lot of news around OpenAI. Well, I mean, throughout the entire year. Starting off though, in January, OpenAI signed a multi-billion investment deal with Microsoft. This deal, this collaboration with Microsoft was finally sealed in January. So this agreement essentially includes scaling supercomputers for OpenAI's research, deploying OpenAI's models across all Microsoft products, and integrating Azure into OpenAI's work. Close collaboration. Which, I mean, when you look down as to the drama that unfolded with OpenAI later on, it's kind of interesting. Now in January as well, other big tech was freaking out about OpenAI, and Google, who was, we could say, a little intimidated or scared by ChatGPT, declared actually a code red for AI development. Now, this was really around Google feeling threatened about ChatGPT and people starting to use it instead of Google to search up different topics. All right, let's move into February. February was equally as busy of a month for companies. Now, listen, I guarantee this whole video will not be covering ChatGPT, although it could very easily because every month something came out. But it would be doing disservice to you if I didn't share that in February, you know, looking back to January, even a month before, how Google was feeling a bit threatened by ChatGPT. In February, they announced Bard to have a bit of rival with ChatGPT. Also in March, UK scientists were awarded 67 million euro for breakthrough in quantum computing. Now this is pretty cool. So back in February, scientists from the University of Sussex and the Universal Quantum were awarded 67 million after making breakthroughs around quantum computing. And these breakthroughs really came for a focus on solving different challenges around medical development, especially around the creation of new materials and climate change solutions. So there, this year as a whole was a big year for the quantum computing world, and we see this right here. There are major breakthroughs happening. Now, Twitter, or X, I should say, really managed to stay in the news throughout the year. Especially in March, though, there were two big things that happened. The first one being that only paid subscribers, it was announced, on X will get recommended in the Twitter For You feed. So this was a big push to really encourage more people to start pouring their own money into Twitter, help Elon out. I don't think he needs any help, but continue to really encourage growth for X, especially in the financial realm. Now, this had a ton of backlash. A lot of users were extremely upset about this. And to top it off in March, there was another big thing that really occurred on X, which was some of its portions of source code got leaked online. This was really interesting. I don't know if you saw the source code. It was nothing too secretive, but it was very interesting the way learning more about how they were ranking users on the social platform, what that looked like. So it was a big year for X, but March specifically. All right, let's move on to April. April was pretty wild. One of my things though that I found most interesting was around Amazon, who in April rolled out their contactless payment technology to over 200 locations worldwide. Now, if you know what I'm talking about, this is using your palm essentially to scan and pay. This is not new technology. This is something they've been working on for quite a while, but it was interesting how this past year, particularly in April, they rolled out across so many stores. The company also signed a deal with Panera Bread, which will see the technology installed in two locations in St. Louis initially. So I'm curious, if anyone lives there, please let me know if you've tried this out. I've never tried out this technology. I see it online. I'm very curious about it. Would you try it out? Also in April, OpenAI released GPT-4, which was a model that was now capable of understanding images and text. This was a big step forward for the world of AI. All right, let's keep it moving. Getting into May here. This was pretty interesting. Well, two things. Let's start with the least interesting out of the two. One being Montana was the first US state to ban TikTok. This occurred back in May. They finally came out that they were starting to ban TikTok. And this ban is set to take place January of 2024. Now, I'm not sure actually, let's search it up. I don't think it's gonna happen. Kind of TikTok ban. Yes, correct. Actually, in November, a few weeks ago, end of November, a federal judge blocked Montana's TikTok ban before it takes place. So, May, there were a lot of stressed out TikTokers out there wondering if they are located in Montana, what is going to happen to them. And now, fast forward a few months, not really a shocker, the ban has been blocked. Now, the one that I found more interesting is the US Food and Drug Administration, the FDA, gave Neuralink back in May thumbs up for human trials. Now, this is a big step forward for Neuralink. They've been testing for many years on animals, specifically monkeys, as we've all seen these trials, and now they got permission to start on humans. The company's goal, as they state, is to help individuals with paralysis, blindness, disabilities, and all through this chip. All right, you can't forget back in June, which feels like, once again, so long ago, but hackers actually threatened to leak the stolen Reddit data if the company didn't pay them $4.5 million. And this was really interesting. This was right around the time of the change that they announced, around their controversial change, I should say, where they were going to update the pricing policy to the usage of their API. I mean, so many companies, so many individuals use their API on a frequent basis that this change announcement would affect them a lot. And Reddit's all about this sense of community, good or bad, but a sense of community, camaraderie. So they were not happy about this. The users were not happy, I should say. Now, I actually just searched up, did Reddit actually pay the hackers? And there's not much news on it. I have a sense that they definitely did not pay the hackers, but I'm very curious. They really shut down that news quite quickly as far as, you know, once it got leaked out that hackers were demanding pay, we never really saw an end to this. Do you know what happened? I'm searching online and I don't see anything about it. I think they shut down the news for it, which I just can't see them paying though. But June was a big month. I mean, that's a lot of stress. All right, let's keep on moving. Going into July, there was a lot of product announcements in July, starting with Apple's announcements at its WWDC 2023 conference. And here are some of the things that they announced, which sound like, you know, we use them every day now, but back then, they were exciting and new shiny things. So they announced the introduction of Apple's Vision Pro, which we haven't seen necessarily yet to the market, but I do think it's coming early 2024. I believe that's what I read. I just don't know. I can see it being used in classrooms for learning purposes. I just don't see myself walking around my house using it, but maybe we're just not there yet. Other things they announced include the 15-inch MacBook Air, the Mac Studio and Mac Pro, and also too with the M2 Ultra chip. So it was a big year for Apple. Then on the flip side, Meta introduced Quest 3. This was weeks apart that this happened. It was both in the same month. And obviously, I believe it was Meta who announced Quest 3 right before Apple came out with their version of the, you know, the Vision Pro. And Quest 3, once again, I don't know. I don't have any friends who use it. I don't think it's really stuck as far as the, you know, average person having a Quest 3 at home. I don't know, do you use it? Very curious to hear, who's using this? Now, August is one of the slower months, I would say, throughout this past year for big tech news. So, you know, there's a few things that happened. Nothing really exciting though to note. I would say, you know, at this time, Meta's Threads was released and it had record signups as far as getting onto the platform, which makes sense. They really implemented it in a way where, you know, users that are already on Instagram are getting pushed directly to Threads. You get this instant high because a lot of your followers are still following you on that platform, but it really declined quickly. It actually reached 100 million signups though, which was outpacing ChatGPT as the fastest growing platform, which is pretty cool, but it definitely didn't stick around. I think there's a bit more pickup for it now, especially with Europe users now being able to use it. Now, similar to August, September was actually pretty quiet. I mean, other than the typical rumblings around what is going on with X, what's happening with TikTok, what's happening with OpenAI, all of those I would say are very commonly threaded throughout the year as being big news. But, you know, to not just continuously repeat about the same types of news, in September, there was a lot of news headlines around, specifically around the climate. And I believe it was because in September, where was it? Ah, yes, in September actually, this is super interesting. Global ocean temperatures were noted to reach unprecedented levels. So the ocean reached a temperature that was hotter than it ever has been recorded before. And I think through that, there was a lot of different speculation, a lot of different talk that came out of that, you know, the ocean being hotter than it's ever been recorded. And how that affects tech, there was a lot of hype around socially responsible apps for 2023, different ways that tech could potentially have the power to help with global sustainability. So this isn't a specific news headline other than, of course, the ocean portion of it, but we saw a lot in September around climate reporting. And then too, there was this positive take in around September, I remember, on how AI could potentially help with these climate issues we are facing. So September was a big month for the climate. All right, we head into October and things start to pick up again. One being, I thought this was really interesting. China launches in October their first commercial human spaceflight program. That's pretty cool. So this was launched and it was the first commercial human spaceflight program that was called Tianzhou, I might be saying that wrong, probably in, which is a cargo spacecraft that will be used to resupply the Chinese space station. The launch is a significant milestone, they go on to say, for China's space program. Very interesting, and you know, this is something I got excited about because it definitely has the potential to pave the way for commercial space tourism in the future. Would you go to space? I think I would, but I wouldn't be the first tourist to go. Maybe, you know, let some others go first and then I'll try it. Also too, with IBM, they developed the new quantum computer that can perform certain calculations millions of times faster than existing computers. So throughout the year, IBM really released some exciting news around quantum computing. And back in October, this was something that they shared as well around a computer that can do calculations millions of times faster. I don't think we realize how impactful or how powerful this will be. We talk a lot about AI. Quantum computing, I think, is gonna just like take everything to the next level. You know, we see how AI has changed our world. Quantum computing will do that, but on steroids. Steroids? Elevated? You know what I mean. Okay, welcome November. You know what November is going to be, or if you don't, you will right when I start giving you hints. Someone very major got fired and then rehired right away. Of course, this is Sam Altman, who was fired as CEO of OpenAI back in November. And then it was over the weekend, there was a lot of drama that happened, only to have, I believe it was Monday, less than a week, he went back and is now again CEO of OpenAI. Employees were outraged at this, that he got let go. Many threatening to quit, many who would have quit if he did not come back. So the board really had no choice but to take him back. And now there are different speculations coming out as to why he got let go, different reports, but you know, at the end of the day, I think the biggest thing is ensuring that transparency is there with the knowledge that, you know, he has, the company has, and maybe there was a little bit of friction at that time with what they were actually sharing and what the board knew. Or I think because AI is moving so quickly, when they hear things about AI or the potential for it, it can get very scary very quickly. What is possible? What does he know is possible? But he's been very vocal about what, you know, not only the good of AI, but also the negative. So I don't know. I'm very happy he's back. I think it's a good move. All right, now December, here we are, end of the year. Let's look back. You know, starting in December was really interesting. This is when Google claimed their new, or shared about their new Gemini AI. There were three models for Gemini. Later came out, about a week later, or a few days later, maybe not even a week, came out around how the video sharing what their model, their AI model Gemini was capable of, came out that parts of it were edited and just not as realistic as to where it is today. I'll link down that video or I'll put it in the cards here because I did do a video comparing Gemini to ChatGPT, GPT-4 in particular, and it's really fascinating. But I do think Gemini in 2024 is really going to take off. Other things that happened was Amazon's CTO shared his tech predictions for 2024, and I thought this was really interesting to include in this. I really look forward to his tech predictions every year because they're kind of out of the box. So two things from his tech predictions stood out for me. The first was a focus on making generative AI culturally aware by addressing biases in language models. Now, this is a huge prediction. I know it doesn't sound that big, but how do you train a model to be culturally aware? That is such a big step forward with AI that if we are able to do it, That's pretty awesome. Another thing he mentioned was the evolution of education to match the speed of technology. Now, this is really interesting to me. He mentions that a shift towards industry-led, skill-based training programs will occur versus the typical traditional degrees. And I think this is something that's been really missing from our education system, is it seems as though during school, we learn a lot of theory, a lot of what-if scenarios, and then we get into the workforce only to be faced with these hands-on, real scenarios. We need more of that mix in the middle where when we are in school, we're actually doing, speaking in the world of technology, more hands-on learnings that are up to date with what is going on, because tech is moving so quickly that we really need to get our educational system at least a little bit closer to that pace. All right, whew, 12 months. It was a wild ride, and I honestly think it was just setting us up for an even bigger ride going into 2024. What do you think? Leave down in the comments some of your predictions going into next year. Hit that subscribe button, and all right, this is my last video I'm filming for 2023, which is pretty crazy. It means I can go eat a lot of cookies now. Bye, everyone.